Hello, sir. I have a feedback on the Mrigashira.
Yes, sir.
I have seen. Actually, I've got a chart from one of my friend, and the chart was his relative's chart, and the mercury was placed in Mrigashira.
Okay.
So, what I told that seeing the chart that this person must be using any VPN connection, or will never give you any read receipts whenever he is. Chatting with you with means in the what do you call this WhatsApp and all.
Wonderful, Milanjiji. What a prediction!
And that was perfectly bang on. He never used to give any read receipts in the WhatsApp. He will. You cannot find out whether he's seeing.
He has read the message or he has not read the message.
Not read the message. He always keeps his hidden.
Wow.
So
Mrigashira Nakshatra. Wonderful.
Mrigashira. And he was very surprised that how that is predicted from the. From seeing the chart, so it was a very wonderful experience. Actually,
see that's the when you know the significations of Mercury now, and you put that in Mrigashira, and there are 10 other things you can predict from this planet only. Like hide the identity, clear the cookies, or do not track, and do not read the read receipts of WhatsApp. These kind of things WhatsApp. Mercury in Mrigashira. Yes, wonderful.
Mercury in Mrigashira, and a bang on exactly.
Yeah. Yeah. Also, whenever his wife will get pregnant, he will never tell anyone.
True. That also actually has happened. I told him he has a problem in the marriage areas also because of a different combination. But this was totally surprised my friend that how is it possible to say from a chart?
See,
yeah, thank you.
When
yeah.
you're predicting that this particular native is not going to show you the read receipts of WhatsApp.
WhatsApp.
Tell me what else you want from the course.
Yeah, he got totally bowled out actually.
Okay. Yes, Babu.
Yeah.
Babu B. Babu.B.
I have a strange incident which has happened in my life. Only once it has happened. Okay. Actually, I visited Kashi, this one, Varanasi, and. The day I was about to means that day was planned to return back to my hometown, and I decided that I should visit the Kaal Bhairav temple at the outskirts. And with my family, I visited that temple without even understanding that the train time is exactly matching the time in which I'm exactly visiting that temple of Kaal Bhairav.
Okay,
so I visited the temple. Then I realized, oh my God, I have totally, I missed the train. So all six, seven peoples, my degree falls in Gemini.
Okay.
That way, that one.
Which is ascendant are you, sir?
I am Virgo.
Okay.
In my life, only once this has happened, that I have missed any kind of these kind of things, only once.
Okay.
And that happened. Only because I decided to visit Kaal Bhairav temple in Varanasi, and I've done visited nicely and all these things happened, but I missed the train and I had to face some big trouble, as you can understand, to get next communication. Strange thing in my life has happened.
Niranjan, tell me one thing. After you visited the temple, did anything significant in your career happen or not?
It a very significant thing happened after the career.
Okay.
Actually, yeah.
Okay.
Means,
where is the Rahu?
Yeah. My Rahu is in this one in Mula Nakshatra in this one in the fourth house.
Okay. Then the house changes.
Yeah, it changed actually. I came to the foreign and all these things has happened. Placed outside and all these things has happened. But a very weird thing. Never.
You know why it happened? You know what is the mistake you did there? I was about to tell you.
It baffles me till date why it had happened.
Okay, I will tell you. I'll clear the mystery for you. You see, the Kaal Bhairav is a Dwarapala, means he's a gatekeeper for the Kashi. When you visit the Kashi, you first visit the Dwarapala.
Okay.
You first visit the person to enter the Kashi. But I'm going to enter the Kashi. Okay. You did it in last.
Last day, last time.
Okay.
Okay.
But still, he gave you the result.
Yes.
Okay.
It was,
now,
it
next
was
time
amazing.
You visit the Kashi, the first thing you should do is And this is a normal procedure for anyone who is going to visit the Kashi Vishwanath temple. Visit the Kaal Bhairav first. He is a Dwarpal for Kashi.
Okay.
Then you go to the Kashi Vishwanath temple. Because you take the permission to enter the city, na? You just can't just waffle around in the city and go to the king first. Because visit the gatekeeper first. And the Kaal Bhairav is a gatekeeper.
Okay. Yes.
So next time onwards, anyone who visits it, please visit the Kaal Bhairav first. Then you go to the temple. Yes, Viraj.
Great. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes, Sudhirji.
Sir, actually, even I visited Kashi in 2010, I suppose.
Okay.
Around October. Okay. So it was to take astikas of my wife's father.
Okay.
So, though my father was still living, even he is alive today, so I had to take because of compulsions with my wife. So, I had taken it with my wife. So, and after that, 2010, when I visited Kashi, after that, I visited this Kaal Bhairav temple after or before, I don't remember.
Okay.
But after that one, 2 months after that, I had... the carriage started falling down for me.
Okay.
So my growth has started falling down.
Okay. Where is your Ardra Nakshatra?
It is first house, Lagna.
Okay. And where is your Rahu?
Sixth house, Scorpio.
Do you know the reason now?
Not able to guess.
Arre Baba. See, sixth house Scorpio is your workplace, careers. Rahu is placed there. And, and where is the Mars placed now?
Mars is in second house, Cancer.
Okay. You see, the sixth house is not devilated in second house. What are you going to expect?
Okay.
I tell you the remedy for it. Next time you visit, what did you offer to Kaal Bhairav or the temple? Did you offer him something?
I don't remember visiting Kaal Bhairav temple itself, but I remember visiting this. Because we were on this site, a lot of temples we were visiting. I'm not sure whether I visited Kaal Bhairav temple before or after. I don't know. So, I don't remember.
Okay. Do one thing. If you this time you visit, there is a particular alcohol made from the jaggery itself.
Okay.
You have a Mars there, na? Debilitated. You offer Kaal Bhairav that particular alcohol, you see your career will start boosting up.
Okay.
And you see, once you have returned back your home, na, after this temple, your family must have had a fight and a very great amount of fight in while traveling in a vehicle. Do you remember that?
No, usually my wife takes all the brunt from me, so I quarrel a lot of with my wife.
No, I said within the family. When I say family, it's not about your wife. I say, within your family means your parents, siblings. Like you must be traveling after. See, once visited a temple, na 12 days from that particular day, you will go and travel in the family. You must be visiting somewhere, and then the fight or verbal fights within the family will happen in the car.
Okay.
Did that happen with you? Do you remember that after 12 days?
Visiting after 12 days because usually I fight with 4 to 5 people. One is my wife, mother, father, and brother. These are the 5 people I've fight.
Okay. So now this has to be a very significant event. Reason being, where is your moon? Come on, yeah. See, now I need to predict for you. I need to confirm the event. Otherwise, no, I will not get the inner peace. Where is your moon?
12th house.
Okay.
Rohini Nakshatra.
Okay, the fight will be regarding the expense which has made you have made regarding the family.
Okay. I gave money to my father regarding some wealth or money, something I might be that might be the case.
Okay, you don't remember, sir. Do you want me to more pinpoint the events now?
Yeah.
Okay. See, once you visit that temple and you activate certain nakshatra, you activate the Ardra Nakshatra. That nakshatra is in sixth house, in this kind of Scorpio, which is related to wealth. The sixth lord goes in the second house, This is a debilitated mass in the family, sign of cancer. That goes in the 12th house and sign of wealth, Rohini Nakshatra. You have given the wealth to the family. The fight happens in the car while traveling. That you said, you're blaming that you, because of you, I invested in this particular property. And that is why, you know, all these problems I'm facing right now. That particular time period, the problems related to property or the investment which you have given to someone, that wasn't a problem.
Okay. So that has happened. Actually, that wealth has gone off. So that investment, whatever I had lent, that has gone off. So it has. I have
Because you are not giving. You are visiting the Dwarpal and you are not carrying anything in your hand, which you should have.
Okay.
Next time you visit, please now take this as a remedy and tell me what happens in 12 days. Okay. Next time you visit, please carry. I'm giving you one of the most biggest secrets. Please carry the alcohol made from jaggery. You can easily get it in the Punjab, or if you don't know how to make it at home, just contact anyone from Punjab. They will get you arranged for you.
Okay.
Jaggery, alcohol made from jaggery. Donate it in the Kaal Bhairav temple.
So I have to visit Kashi to donate or anywhere?
Visit Kashi to donate.
Okay.
Tell me in the 12 days, the results will happen.
Anytime. Even tomorrow also I can go and visit.
Yes, why not?
Okay.
Babuji, this particular technique I explained in the Para Brahman Padati. Yes, Vinay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yeah, like I have an horoscope of a lady like who has got moon in Ardra Nakshatra in 8th house. Weird thing is like one thing I got is she always blames her husband. Mm-hmm. The second thing is like for she is like a little bit rich kind of person. Mm-hmm. But for the past 25 years, she goes and cleans the temple always, the lady goddess temple.
Okay.
And she does this every day.
Did she started doing it after the marriage problems?
Yes, after marriage.
Okay. Wonderful. Okay. Murthy ji, you are very senior.
Yes, sir.
Please tell me, how's the course for you?
Course is very nice. Today I want to share something to you.
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
I just heard Bharani Nakshatra thing.
Okay.
It's working very nicely. For example, my daughter's chart, Bharani is in first pada.
Okay.
So it goes to Leo Navamsha.
Okay.
You told about a Brahmin stealing gold and other things, no?
Yes.
His son is Jupiter. See, Jupiter is in Bharani Nakshatra, first pada.
Okay.
He's a Scorpio Lagna. So, fifth house is son. Son is Jupiter, Lagna Lord. Mm-hmm. So, Jupiter is in first pada. Mm-hmm. He's going on spending a lot of money on his first son.
Ah, wow. Wonderful. So
even though she is not, sometimes she can't afford, still she will spend.
Wow. Because?
The same thing, she may not spend on second son.
The first one is anyhow favorite, sir. Huh? The first kid is always favorite. But
here in this case, see the Jupiter, Brahmin, Leo, gold, everything comes very nicely.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
And also this Jupiter is situated in 6th house of her.
Okay. So it's giving the money. Spending money on her. Even if you can't afford. Wonderful. Now, today's
topic. Another thing also works very well. See this Bharani, you said death will happen, birth will happen.
Yes.
When she was conceived, the first child, my father died.
Then the son is born. When the male person dies, male person comes back.
Correct.
When the female goes, female comes back.
Correct. This Bharani works very fantastically.
Yes. This is with the Bharani principle, you can always not notice male and female. Whenever you see it with the fifth house linked with the fifth lord or with the Jupiter, or anywhere with the childbirth, if the male member of the family has gone, the male member of the family will come back.
Oh,
if the female member of the family has gone, the female member of the family will come back.
Oh, very nice, very nice.
This is the this is I learned from somewhere, I don't remember now from whom I learned this particular technique. But yes, with Bharani it works that way. Like he used to ask who has died in your family recently, because when you ask whether it be boy or girl, and there are certain ways to tell it, but he will ask who has died in your family. If you say this, the female has died, said okay, the female girl is coming, or girl is coming in your family. Wow. That's it.
Wow.
So in your case as well, it will hold true. Male member will go, male member will come back.
Yes, back to Bharani.
Yeah, that's for Bharani.
Same person or another person in the family?
Come back.
Will it be the same person coming back?
Will see the person who has gone. Let's suppose grandfather in this particular case, or grandmother in particular case, whatever. The native who is coming will have same kind of qualities. Like one case I know, the grandmother used to have a certain passion for cooking, and you know, all the homeworks. And the girl who has come in the family, from a very young age, she has started YouTube channel for cooking. You see, the same traits of that person will come into him.
Sir,
yes, ma'am.
Sir, I have one feedback about Trika Nakshatra.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, you had said that whatever we give into the fire, we have to be very careful when Kritika, when we have prominent stars in Kritika.
Yes.
So, what happened is, the person is worried that the person is not getting a job.
Okay.
Or, there is a lot of unrest in the family because of that reason.
Okay.
So what happened is I suddenly saw the Kritika Nakshatra, and it was like Moon and Jupiter in Kritika in 11th house.
Okay.
And in Taurus Lagna. So I said you have ate a lot of roasted non-vegetarian food.
Okay.
And all this stuff. That is why you are not she said, how are you predicting non-vegetarian stuff? When did I eat? I said, yes, you ate you started eating non-vegetarian and roasted food. That is why you lost the job. You stopped doing that and give ahuti, havan samagri, ahuti, and this thing, you will get a job.
Okay.
So we are just waiting for that portion. She'll do the remedy.
But did she confirm the prediction?
Yeah, she confirmed the prediction that she ate lots of roasted, baked, non-veg items during that time.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
No problem. Yeah.
So I've been, when you said that ninth from when Rahu transits Ardra, and ninth of it would suffer.
Yeah.
And so I've been thinking about it through the class. And so right now I've Sun and Mercury in Ardra in my eighth house because I'm a Scorpio ascendant. And Rahu is transiting my eighth. And I also have a Mercury Antardasha going on.
Mm-hmm.
So my fourth is the 11th. So sign of Aquarius, which is my fourth house.
Okay.
And my Mars is in the ninth house. So Rahu started transiting Ardra.
Mm-hmm.
I believe that was in September, right?
Yeah.
So I've had a lot of problems with my car. So I got a speeding ticket in New York in September.
Okay.
Then in October, my neighbor hit my car. So that was a damage of $7,000 or whatever. Then again, my car came back after a month from repair. And within 3 days in December, it got hit again.
Okay.
And then again, it went to the garage. And then within that period, my dad has had robbers come to his business twice.
Okay.
Also in us. Around the same time my car gets hit,
mm-hmm.
he has robbers come to his property and he has had to call the cops. But it's been happening over and over. And now I'm scared to drive. So I haven't driven in a month and my brother drops me off to the work.
Okay, now you know how to drive these people away, right?